Here today I would be talking about the Tableau interface. So firstly, talking about like what is Tableau. So Tableau is a software which is used for data visualization, and it is basically used for business intelligence purpose. Now, what are these technologies, data analytics, and business intelligence? So what they mean is that based on any data, what is the information which is getting out of it and presents that information in form of a story, that is data visualization. Tableau is one of the best tool for this purpose, and I would be just talking briefly about the interface of Tableau today. Now what you see here is the landing page of Tableau. You can see on the left hand side, so I've already loaded a data of Superstore, Global Superstore data, and then these are the different columns which are present. Now if you see, they are divided into two parts. One is dimension and one is measures. So dimension is basically those columns which display my data, which like for example the country or the gender or the name of the person. And measures are all the quantitative data which is on which I can do any measurements, like the sum of sales or the total quantity which I have sold, etc. So this takes the columns into dimensions and measures. You can easily move any one column from one section to another by just pulling and dragging it. So this category has come as measure, but since it's a descriptive column, it is taking it as a count. So you again change that as required, but I will suggest to keep as mentioned right now. So as control Z and take it back to the dimension. Now inside, this is where we create the visuals. So right now, we have opened our first worksheet, which is sheet one. Shelves. So all these are called shelves. Column shelf, row shelf, page filters and marks. I'll be talking about each of them separately. So let's start creating with a visual first. So I will pick up any one particular column from my dimensions. Suppose it is order date. I can drag it in the columns and take. So I want to see how my sales has been happening across the years. Certain rows. Now you see there's a color differentiation first. Blue colors showcase that it is coming from a dimension and it is discrete. And green one is coming from a measure and it is continuous. So what really happens is that what Tableau considers is that all measures are considered to be continuous for the most of the time. And for this considered as discrete. How we can change it as and when required, continuous to discrete or vice versa. So let's just take a simple example that I want to see my total sales for a year. So we generated a trend line and showing that my sales is increasing from 2011-2014. Now on the top we have this show me button. So if I click over it, these are the different visuals which I can create on these two data sets, data points. So create a bar chart. So if we see the line trend has changed into a bar line and the axis has also changed. Now if you bring change the axis again, we just need to swap it. And the years on x-axis and the total sales on y-axis. Now here I want to see month, then I click this drill down button and see there are option of showing it in month. So now my 4 years of data in terms of month trend. Now left side we have these three shelves. I will first talk about the mark shelf. Now, mark shelf does is that it handles the different characteristics of this visual. For example, changing the color, changing the size, some label and things. So first I talk about the color. Now right now we are seeing only two data points. One is the sales, and another is the time period. Now suppose I want to see that how different countries are performing, then I will just drag this country itself. Then either there are hundreds of countries according to which my sales is getting split up. Now only some particular countries only, then I'll again pull this country in filters. Now here in this pop-up we are getting that there are multiple countries, and if I want to see any the top five, and I see the country information for the five of them which I selected, and to add that filter dynamically I just enter and click show filter. Right hand side we can see the different countries which are selected, and here I can easily add or delete any particular country. Now if I want to change the size based on my total profit, then I can just drag profit and pull it. Now I can see the bar chart changing. So the more the width, the more is the profit margin. So I will control Z right now, and I will put the profit as a label. So now label for each of the breakouts. So I can say that yeah, out of 808 sales, 182 was the profit made for this for Algeria in January 2011. So you can read this information. Now if I want to add some more details or delete any of the information, then I click on tooltip, and here are present by default by tab blue, and some are the one which we have added on our own. Now suppose I want to add more like information, I will click and put in tooltip. Click tooltip. Now this region has also come up entry. We can see that region Africa is also present right now in the information. Now one of the which I have spoken in workshop. Now if I want to change the format of any of the visuals, so you click on format, I can add shading, borders, change the font or the alignment. So if we see, the information which we see is sales which has been made by each country for different months. If I want to add another information of profit which is made in each month, I just drag profit and put it label or tooltip. So first I will put it in labels. Label values are getting populated on bar chart. And if I it, I can see Algeria in January 2011, I had sales of 808 units, and out of that a profit was of 182 units. Now talking about the tooltip, so right now we are seeing only the four information. If I need to add some more information, I will drag that column in tooltip. So for example, I want to see the region information. Region and put it over. I can add another a line called region has been added, which is Africa. So Algeria is part of Africa, and the profit and sales made for it. Now change anything in the tooltip. I can click tooltip and I can see some columns are coming in by default by tab blue, and some we have added like the region. Now mentioning it as country, I want to this country name, then I add it here. But instead of month of order date, I just want to mention month. This can be controlled this pop-up bar. I can see edited column names. This is the country name and month. And by the way, just for this visual, it doesn't change the exact the actual column name. That's the same. Okay, so like some of the elements which I showcase for to build a visual. Now if I want to control any of the formatting, I can format and change some of the elements like the font, the element, the rating, others, etc. Now let me just change the font of this. Now here, let's change for the tooltip. So tooltip to be highlighted in green. It's a bold, the bit format. It we can see the formatting being applied on the tooltip. Similarly, if I want to do, I can control it in many ways. I will click on label. I can click on this font. Increase the size of the profit which I can see. So easy to control all the features of the visual in Tableau. Now I will another update and show you some of the geo coding capabilities of Tableau. Now in this set we have called state, country, city, and that there's an icon which is showing that Tableau is able to capture it the geo column itself. Now click on country, and you can is able to populate each names. Is coming from OpenStreet contributors, so it is connected to online, so it takes little time to populate. If you see that Tableau was able to populate all the countries. Now what I want to do is that I want to see that where is my sales happening the most. So I will just drag the sales, pull it in size by. So now we see that the size of each bubble has changed according to the quantity, so based on the sales which was done in that particular country. So for India, it was around 0.5 million. Let's say states, it was 2.2 million sales. Now to add the element of color, like so if I want to see for each region how my countries are doing, just drag this region in color bar. So for this region, for Southeast, Central Asia, sorry, so Central Asia, in West, whereas in Europe, France, so it's easy to visually identify that which are my best performing countries for each region. So moving ahead, I will just drag these sheets in dashboard. So what you can do is you can story out of the visuals which I created. Okay, just drag those two sheets on a dashboard and increase the size of desktop to cover the complete area of the and see document by default both the visuals are coming on the right hand side. So don't require, we just need to click on it and pick. Okay, now if I want to connect these two visuals so that we can do it using this option called is that by clicking on sheet 1, sheet 2 should get populated. So I will just check sheet 2 from option, sheet 1 from second option. and any of the bubble chart, bar chart should change. If I click on India, on India, at the bottom changes to show only for India. Now anywhere in the white area, then I see the original chart again. Now for Australia, I will just need to click on Australia, and now I can see the bar chart changing only for Australia. Now if I compare two countries, then I just control say, and select United States. So now see the inflation for India and US in the bottom chart. So interactive Tableau is, and how you can play around with your data. So for today, it was just a beginning of what all Tableau can do. In further lectures, we can talk in details. So thank you.